3 million overweighted, 700 million it's obese, like a third percent of population, of mundial population. And there are genetic components, behavioral, psychological, social, metabolic, and endocrine, and included in this problem. Increased morbidity, second to increased insulin resistance, diabetes, hypertension, and dyslipidemia. Metabolic syndrome can be defined as a set of cardiovascular risk factors, including insulin resistance, abdominal obesity, glucose intolerance, hyperlipidemia, increased triglycerides, and decreased HDL and hypertension. The association of abdominal circumference and BMI can offer a community-based risk assessment to help to reduce the limitations of each isolated evaluation. The table proposed by the WHO summarizes the risk assessment associated with these measures. So it's the risk you can compare with this table. So I have to relate basically in type 2 GM. When you have obesity, you increase 10 times risk type 2 GM. So for each increase 10% in weight, you increase 2 mg fasting DC. And waist circumference is more than 100 cm, you increase risk of GM 3.5 times even after control for BMI. The increase in adipose tissue increases the demand for insulin as well as insulin resistance and increased glucose in hypersomnia. So obesity, hypertension, and dyslipidemia, each 1% reduction in body weight translates into a decrease of 1 millimeter HG and systolic blood pressure and the diastolic pressure of 2 and 1 kilo weight loss reduces the LDL cholesterol level by 1%. So, this is the question. Why treat high blood pressure if not recognize that the patient can also be dyslipidemic? Or treat diabetes ignoring its morbid obesity and dyslipidemic? Today, it's known that the burden of the syndrome has 2.5 times the risk of cardiovascular death. So, I need to remember the increased waist circumference, high HG, low HDL, elevated blood pressure, and GGC fashion component. It's the components of the metabolic cycle. So, the treatment, and I have to make this treatment about BMI, more or equal than 45 kilos per meter. Decrease life expenses and increase the cardiovascular. So in Johnston at Sweden, in this study, 10 years observation, bariatric surgery is a constant feature in several obesity with clinical treatment failure. And this decreases mortality, improves clinical comorbidities, quality, and obese lifetime. So this problem is solving physical and physical social. And the indications, the Ministry of Health and the CFM resolution from Brazil, and indicates this treatment to age more than 16 and less than 65 years. And with comorbidities like diabetes, dyslipidemia, hypertension, dyslipidemia, coronary heart disease, osteoarthritis, and this is the indications of the bariatric surgery to treat the obesity in this disease. Surgical techniques have restrictions, and the first one is adjustable gastric band. So small strap is inflated, and you decrease the storage capacity of the stomach, decrease the filling rate of the stomach, and set in at any time after the operation. Decrease surgical complications, and morbidity, mortality, faster return to daily It's a good option for when you so balance intergastric, it's closer to circular prostate endoscopy, feeling of fullness and cessation. And pre-surgical weight loss to minimize the aesthetic surgical risk of superobesity, BMI above 15 kilos. And predominantly restrictive procedures is gastric bypass is the first and the best. So the GIIR is the preferred surgery, good standard of treatment, surgery obesity. Brazil is the best. And the small gastric pouch of chamber, the exclusion of the rest of the stomach, the duodenum, and the early jejun. Anastomosis with isolated jejun and lumen in line. And the secretions from the stomach and duodenum flow into the jejun with exclusion. Decrease intake and increase hormones, like satiety and increase hunger, weight loss, diabetes control, and lose pressure. At the arrival of food in the more distal portion of the small intestine, so it's increased ghrelin levels, and clearly signaling of GLP-1. This is reducing gastric emptying and increase insulin secretion and promotes central secretion. And polypeptide I, it's a hormone which decreases the motility and increases satiety. So the next one is sleep gastric. And I cut up about 2/3 of the stomach to reduce capacity and cause restriction. Double action. First is restrict the amount of food ingested, like 2 some hormone, reducing the number. No interference with the absorbed site iron, calcium, zinc, and B complex vitamins. Predominant malabsorption procedures is bilopancreatic reversal, BPG, with gastrectomy. The name is scoplaro, it's the result of gastrectomy. The surgery exclusion of the duodenum, jejunum, and in common intestinal loop, pancreatic. Bile secretion for distal ileum. So, secretion in bile pancreatic is absorption of protein, fat, and elastic food. The next one is bile pancreatic vessel with duodenal switch, and it's a total gastric vertical sleep, preservation, and excluding parental and principal cells, so it's the incidence of osteoporotic cancer happening with bile pancreatic reversal. It's vertical. And the duodenum is actually 2 centimeters from the pelvis. And the distal osteoporosis is about 100 centimeters from the pelvis. Actually, it's comparison of aesthetics and when you compare the interest of gastric bending vertical gastrectomy. We find some studies and had a trial in 2012 assessed that weight loss with insulin concentration, vitamin, glucose, TG, HDL, cholesterol, through this comparison. So both procedures, it's a significant reduction in the BMI, insulin concentration, glucose. There are no difference of this adjusted gastric bending and vertical gastric. But ghrelin decreased more in GV. And Alexander in 2005, it's 39 months, and here it's GM2. And bile pancreatic reversal resolved the GM2 99%. And in rogues and Y, only 89% is resolved GM2. 2 years after this resolution of GM2, I found 100% in bile pancreatic and only 66% in Ruben UI. And this is basically the most. So in IBM in 2012, so population of GM2 and BG28, GV52, and bilirubin version 74 and YNO 72. Gracias Solano with 542 releases for more bilirubins. And this is the numbers of each one. And you can see the batch from units. It's a PG, but some applications. And I will talk about this. That in general is vestibular metabolic surgery. It's a possibility of growth of the liver and various parameters that make up the metabolic cycle. To compare the results between the main types of bariatric surgery, the treatment of obesity and metabolic cycle. So, after evaluating the various studies in hand, bariatric surgery is effective in weight loss, achieving remission, or resolution of type 2 diabetes. And you have to consider surgical risk, weight loss, complications, changes, and comorbidities, quality of life, and regulations. And the bilirubin diversity, it's great in weight loss, like at 7 to 9%. But this problem is malabsorbed to fat soluble vitamins A, G, A, K, and minerals, iron, and calcium. Best techniques for more obesity due to their greater loss and resolution of weight, which has a high comorbidity, anemia, and malnutrition problems that you have to understand. In ruin and life, it's better life, lower reoperation rate, choose less aggressive, normal is
Doctor, you got 2 minutes more.
High probability of remission of GM2, it's oral diabetes for it. So the impact in the bariatric surgery in metabolic syndrome, it's to regardless of the technique performed, effective treatment and metabolic syndrome. Final considerations is poor results in the clinical treatment of metabolic syndrome raises number of bariatric surgeries and procedure effective in the treatment of obesity grade 2, like any pharmacological treatment. And desabsorption surgeries, Copenhagen and the duodenal switch, it's very effective in the treatment of MS, but of the later weight loss, problem of aspect related to metabolic syndrome, and metabolic surgery is effective, creates the motivation of the metabolic syndrome is associated with obesity, leading to transdirection, and all mortality rates generated by cardiovascular disease, generate a lot more search needs. In the distant future, increasing population life expectancy. Yes, it's plausible think that surgery allows to treat the epidemic in the center will be the central surgery with remission rates of obesity and comorbidities association, which have been hardly achieved by pharmacology.
Thank you. Any questions from the audience? Thank you, Dr. Soros. You did the. Just a suggestion. You made a long way by coming from Brazil, and few slides were mixed in Portuguese. We unfortunately don't understand Portuguese, so we missed some information. Just for your consideration in the future.